It's a very simple case. And the issues are very simple, I think. You know, the questions are the acts of the governor reviewable? And if they are, is the publication requirement of Section 124 a condition precedent to a governor granting having the power to pardon? And third, what constitutes publication for 30 days? First of all, let me agree with the appellants that we agree that the wisdom of the governor in granting a pardon and to whom he grants a pardon or she grants that pardon is not an issue that we are concerned with. The wisdom, the decision that they decide who to pardon and so forth. What a court does have jurisdiction to address is whether or not that pardon itself is valid, whether it violates our Constitution. So many of the cases that the appellate...
In your brief, you refer to numerous facially invalid pardons. What constitutes a facially invalid pardon? First question. Of the 10 pardons that are before this court this morning, are you alleging that any of those 10 are facially invalid, and if so, why?
Well, Your Honor, it's our contention that those pardons did not comply with the constitutional requirements of the publication for 30 days.
But my question is, were they facially invalid?
Well, Your Honor, I don't think that is really the issue.
My question, General Hood.
Well, please
answer my question, not tell me what the issue is. And I don't want to argue with you this morning.
Yes, sir. I apologize. I wasn't intending to argue with the court. What the pardons, they don't say, the ones that I've reviewed do not say, you know, whether publication was requirement was met. Now, there are pardons that do that we think are valid. So we contend that the pardons are facially invalid. But there again, Your Honor, respectfully, we disagree that whether or not it's on the facial is valid or not. The question, I believe, is whether or not a court has the authority to review it. And there again, we agree that the wisdom of granting a pardon is not justiciable, not an issue that we're bringing to this court. It's just whether or not those pardons met the constitutional